Alright, now you're inside the corner suite bathroom. As you can see, nice big bathtub over here. Guys, my name is Causette, aka the eShop Game Pig, and today, welcome to the Mandarin Oriental. Sorry about my skin, a lot of pimples over here, not been sleeping that much, and I got kind of skin. Currently, you inside the living room of the quarter suite, and it's featuring some binoculars, so we can check out what's over there at Rosewood.
We can actually see Rosewood. Oh, I know a lounge or something.
Wait, what is this for? I'm not a binocular genius. I don't know how this works.
I'm not
sure. First of all, let's talk about what is this cupboard right here. So, this is the valet box. They can access the valet box from the outside. So I ordered an SCMP at 7 o'clock. Once it's 7 o'clock, I can just come out here and open this cupboard, and then the SCMP newspaper will be ready for my disposal. Yeah, pretty standard. And you can see this is the living room. This is the working desk. They have the Bose. I think this is the mini sound link. The view of the corner suite Mandarin Oriental, featuring the Queen Statue Park and also a little side harbor view over there. And across, that's the Hong Kong Club building, I think. All right, come all the way here. This is the closet, so where we put our bags right here. And we got a safe box, which we will not use. Right behind us is the highlight of the whole room, which is the nice bathtub in the middle. This is not automatic, it's a manual. This is way up. I don't think we can pull it up. Oh,
you mean?
No, I think it's this one. This one, this one should be needy. On the left. Yeah, I don't think we can open these. We have the shower area right here, right inside. Oh, there's a sitting area here.
Okay.
There's the standard massage shower heads. And then we have some shower gel, shampoo.
Diptyque.
Yeah, from Diptyque. Diptyque. Last but not least, we have the bedroom. I think this is a king size bed. King size. Sponsored by Evian. Not plastic, it's a glass water, complimentary water. And then, we're back to the living area right here. It's only 1:30 and we had an early check-in at around like 12 o'clock, but then you can check in early as 10 o'clock and then you can check out latest at 6 p.m. the other day. Tomorrow is gonna be a long day. We were pretty lucky this time again. Initially booked the Square Garden room. However, they considered upgrading us to the same room, but then towards the harbor view. And then after that, they saw us recording some B-roll and stuff, and they asked us, oh, actually, we're just gonna upgrade you to the Square Garden suite. So here we are, we're lucky enough to have an upgrade thank you for the staff. The staff was super, super nice. It was super detailed. She explained us where we could get breakfast. So there's three choices. Wait, let me get the notes that she prepared for me. So as you guys can see, this is the leaflet. So it says the restaurant and bars. First of all, she said that in room is till 11 a.m. So 11 a.m. last order if we choose in room breakfast. Cafe croissant. I have no idea how to say this word. Causette. It's from 6:30 to 11:30, and the Clipper Lounge, the famous Clipper Lounge, that's from 7 to 10:30. So if we can't wake up at 10:30, we can head to the other place, Cafe Croissant, for another extra hour of breakfast. That's how the check-in process went. Oh, the check-in process was pretty fast. We checked in at like 12 o'clock. We just only had to wait 10 minutes. We just had to leave our contact number and then sat below Clipper Lounge and just waited for a call. Yeah, as you can see, I was like kind of sleeping because I didn't have much sleep last night. Well, yeah, the check-in process was good. There's of course no butler service. That's it.
Got it. Did you see the bowl?
I got a bowl, bruh.
Ta-da!
Oh!
It's in here. It's
pretty cool.
Serve for dinner. We got steak, a couple of carnivores, some bread, clam chowder. Alright, total honest review guys, the food here is meh, 50 points out of 100. The only good thing about it is the clam chowder soup. I like it. The ribeye is a little bit rare and it's hard to chew. I think the mashed potato is good. Mashed potato is good.
Just had a turn down service, salt scrub. We wish you a peaceful and relaxing night. To help you plan tomorrow's activity, here's the weather forecast. Partially cloudy, that's a tick. Got some breakfast menu. I believe this is in-room breakfast. There's extra pillows. And come into the bathroom. Everything is neatly organized, as you can see. She also gave us some microfiber cleaning cloth.
It's in the lane box.
What is it?
Made it.
Bye. the Chinery, located on the first floor of MO, place been around since 1963 and still look fresh after 60 years. It is home to one of the world's largest collections of single malt. The service was premium. We had two different kinds of whiskeys, a whiskey sour that afternoon, and oh my god, chicken wings were bomb.
Came back from the Chinery. The Chinery was pretty good. There's not a lot of people. But then after that, we still have 2 hours in the room. 2 hours in the room, we only have one thing left to do. That one thing, the bath, you know, the big bath. And I'm already suited up, suited in my Mandarin Oriental bathrobe, silk robe. Ooh, silky. And then yeah, I'll see you guys in the bath.
This is rare. This is rare. This
is rare. This
is rare. This is rare. This is rare. My hair is a mess. It is a mess. Currently we're checking out and yeah, it's been a pretty good stay so far. Service is pretty good. The indoor dining food was kind of meh. But then we brought you guys to the Chinery. That's a pretty good place to hang if you guys want a nice place and good whiskey. This is it from the eShop Guinea Pig. I guess I'll see you guys in the next video. And if you guys like this video, please hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, and probably comment if you guys want. But I'll see you guys next time, eh? This is the lobby, and peace out.